On this week's Xamarin Essential API of the Week, I show you how to open the browser directly from your mobile app. Welcome back, everyone, to another Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Today, we're going to take a look at the Open Browser API, part of Xamarin Essential, that helps you launch the browser application to a specific URL. What's really cool is that you can use the default launcher or use the system-optimized browsers such as Chrome Custom Tabs and SF Safari View. So let's take a look to see how to implement it. Here's my sample application that I've been using for all of the Xamarin Essential API videos. And what I've done is I've added a button or a label that can be clicked for forgot password. Now here you'd probably want to launch and open up a forgot password website so your users can reset their password. So to get started with Xamarin Essentials, we're going to head over to our documentation, just like we always do. Ensure that you open up the Getting Started guide to install Xamarin Essentials, and then you can browse through all the featured guides. Here is the Open Browser guide. Now it's really easy to get started because all you have to do is call open async and pass in a few commands to it, and that will automatically launch the URL, which is either a string or a URI, to the browser. So let's see how we can implement this. Over in our code, I've gone ahead and installed Xamarin Essential into all of my projects. And inside of my main activity, I've of course added my Xamarin Essentials initialization code and my code for permissions here on Android. And that's in the Getting Started guide. And of course, I'll put links in the show notes for this. Now on our login page, we have this label. This label says forgot password, the text color is blue, has the underline, and then I have a tap gesture recognizer for the label that when clicked will go ahead and get executed. So now over in the code behind for this page, I have that forgot password tapped. Now for any Xamarin Essential API, we're going to go and want to add the using statement for Xamarin Essentials. Else down here, we'll see that I could type in Xamarin.Essentials. If I zoom in, we'll see that I get all of the APIs available in Xamarin Essentials. And here is the browser API. So instead of adding that Xamarin Essentials, since we added the using statement, I'll say dot. And inside my IntelliSense, I'll see open async. Now there are a few options and parameters I can pass in, such as a string, a URI, and this browser launch mode, which I'll talk about here in a second. So let's just go ahead and open up Xamarin.com, and then we can give it a browser launch mode. Now here we're going to see that the browser launch mode is either external or system preferred. This is optional, and by default, it'll use system preferred. The external launcher means that it's going to open the browser outside of your application. So it's completely launching a new activity outside. Whereas system preferred, if available, will use the optimized browser, such as Chrome Custom Tabs and SF Safari View Controller. This allows you and your user to stay inside of your application, and it gives a more delightful experience. So here we go. I'll just go ahead and add system preferred. Now this is an async task, and this will fire off and await to ensure that the browser has been launched. So go ahead and await on that, and we'll mark this as async. There we go. So now when I go ahead and run my application again, what we're going to see is that with that single line of code, it will automatically launch my browser. So let's go ahead and let it recompile. And here we go. The app has relaunched, and all I have to do is tap on forgot password, and just like that, it opens up. I can see now everything I need to know about Xamarin, and we can notice here that when I tap on the top right triple dot menu, we can see that this is powered by Chrome, and I could even launch Chrome from this part. But the nice thing here is that if I hit the X, I'm immediately back into my application. The user doesn't have to switch contexts. And that's it. With literally a single line of code, you're launching your browser with optimized settings such as Chrome Custom Tabs. If I ran that on iOS, SF Safari View Controller as well. You can find all the links for the documentation and this sample application in the show notes below, and check out all of the awesome Xamarin Essential API videos of the week. Thanks for watching. Hey, it's James. I'm just checking in and wanted to thank you for watching this awesome Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Now, don't forget to do all the things, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell for even more videos. And while you're here, check out more Xamarin Essential API videos of the week. They're all right here. Go do it right now. It's awesome.